Hello everyone, and welcome to a quick look at the MechWarrior 2 hook for Windows XP created by Chris Porter, aka Slug. This nice little program allows you to play MechWarrior 2, Ghostmare's Legacy, or Mercenaries on XP with very little trouble whatsoever. You're not going to have to do any hex editing or any other patching whatsoever in order to get this to run. Usually. There are some exceptions though, but we'll get into that later. For now, though, you should also note that this won't work on Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8, or any other version of Windows that comes down the pike, unfortunately. It also doesn't work on the DOS, Titanium, or Battlepack editions. But if you have a normal Windows 95 version, chances are you're going to want to use this method. It's very simplistic. You just install it wherever you want. And it will probably detect the game. If it does not detect the game, you're going to have to do a few other things, which is the main focus of this tutorial. If it does detect it, you want to hit yes, and it'll say that it can't set the compatibility mode, but it actually does, and I'll prove that in just a second. It sets it to the Windows 95 compatibility mode. You can set it to Windows 98 if you like, it doesn't matter. You might also turn off the visual themes. But keep that in mind for those of you that it does not detect it for, you're going to want to set the compatibility settings. But if you have it detected, then your game's running. There's nothing more to it. It also is going to run in the background, the little console here. Do not close it. If you do, it will crash the game. So keep that in mind. Now, if it can't detect it, what you need to do is create a shortcut on the desktop or wherever you want, pretty much, and have it locate the MechWarrior 2 hook directory and MechWarrior 2 exe. Inject.exe, I apologize. You can call this whatever you want. I'm going to call it Mech 2 hooked in this case. There's more to it, though. You need to edit the target path so that it is at the MechWarrior 2 directory. In my case, it was slightly different, but for most people, you just go to the directory and paste the directory path and type mech2.exe. That's it. Your game will run. However, if you actually have done any patches to the game, you're going to have to do a few more things. If you want to see the switches that this has, you look at the console and point it to mech2inject.exe, and you get the listing as you see here. You got the startup switch, mech lab switch, heat pack switch, frame rate limit switch. In most cases, you're going to want to have the slash startup and the mech lab. You need to put that in between the two sets of paths. So what you do is put slash startup, slash dash, and mech lab. What this does is it turns off the mech lab fix as well as the startup fix. This is only necessary though if you've used Consta's method or the slug's patch that he had created in the past. Why would you want to use that in combination with this? Well, despite the fact that it says that it fixes the mech lab overweight issue, I found that in many cases, it actually does not. So if you combine the patch with Consta's, most of the time, it'll solve the problem with the overweight bug, and you'll want to do that. Also, in combination with that, if you use the hook, sometimes this will solve the jump jet issue as well as the missile problem, because as you see on the screen, it says the frame rate limit that you could turn off. Well, if you leave it on, it'll supposedly fix the jump jet and missile problems. Pretty much, that's it. The game will run from this point, assuming, of course, that you have those two things already installed with those switches. If you don't have those installed, then remove that and just have it a space between the two, and it'll run. If you guys have any problems, you're also welcome to visit the Mech2 forums and post up a support request, and sometimes you'll be able to get some help, sometimes not. Most of the time, we're relatively helpful, so come take a look over here, and as always, thank you again. Take care.